Going on, what's going on? Show. I'm BBS. This is Christian, and together we're your Unofficial Boys podcast. This week we have an awesome show for you guys. We'll be discussing religion being more dangerous than porn. All right, remember that. The World Series champs, learning moose, your wife being right for once, and a neo-Nazi airport. Again, I'm Jeremy, and this is my main man, Christian, and we're your unofficial boys.
No, all right. I don't even know half of what's going on because I didn't read the thing.
per usual.
What are you talking about? Usually I'll type out a lot of
We got Christian over here confused and not knowing what's going on, out of order, you know?
It's pretty normal, if I'm being honest.
But I like your hat. Where'd you get that hat from?
I got it from a golf shop in Naples, Florida.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. What is it, like par three or something like that?
Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure it stands for par three. Yeah.
Okay.
It's an Adidas hat.
Oh, wait, so it's an Adidas company? Like Adidas made that hat? Oh, I was asking if par three was like the name of the company, the brand.
Yeah, no, Adidas makes the hat.
Very nice.
I had never seen this hat before, and I just stumbled upon it in the store, and I was like, oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
Nathan, it's got like little birds and golf clubs for birdies and golf.
Is that like under the broom? That's cool.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, shout out the Giants. Beat the Raiders. You know what I'm saying? They somehow are coming out with wins out of their belt. That was Shaquan.
Shout out coming to back the Panthers this weekend for ruining my hopes and dreams. But that's besides the point.
Oh man, but you want to go ahead and start diving in on into the beers of the week?
Yep, let's get it.
Beers of the week. Got beer of the week for me right here. You know what I'm saying? Got a nice little Stone. Buena Vesa. Salt and lime added already. None needed. You know what I'm saying? That's a little 4.7.
Dude, I freaking love that beer.
Oh man, dude, it's such a nice beer. I had it. I was doing a little campfire, a little bonfire last night.
Have you had it with lime in it?
Yeah, I had it last night.
I'm pretty sure that was the one that I was telling everybody to put lime in it.
I'm crying. Well, it already has a little bit of salt and lime added to it. You can
taste
it.
It's okay. More lime adds more flavor. That's how it goes.
So, the Stone Buena Vesa Salt and Lime Lager was actually born in Southern California, which is vibrantly influenced by our neighbors to the south, you know, Mexico. Brewed with just the right amount of lime and sea salt, it's everything a lager could be: crisp, refreshing, and full of flavor. It really goes well with, like, you know, anything Mexican food-wise, tacos and, you know, nice little salty meats.
Dude, it's tacos.
I mean, dude, fish tacos, freaking
dude, that any type of tacos. Right, that drink right there is my relaxation drink. Like,
yeah.
I'm usually, like, my go-to is a Corona, but that is now my new go-to whenever I see it in the store.
Yeah, it's about the same price.
Yeah, well, actually, I think it might be a hair cheaper. I think I find that one a little more often than I do Corona.
Yeah, I can see that definitely. Corona never goes on sale. But yeah, this is definitely a good beer. I give it a 4, definitely a 4.
My man.
Absolutely, I give it a 4, dude. That's a really good beer that you can have summer, winter, and you can enjoy it. Enjoy it by the fire. You can enjoy it inside. Go try it out.
I think I either gave it a 4 or 4.5 on my
Untappd.
Yeah, on my Untappd. Oh, I don't remember.
Nice. Oh, absolutely. Dude, yeah, no, without a doubt, I'll give it a 4.
There was one So we went up to Maryland one time, and we went to like one of those Total Wine places that has like thousands of wines and every like beer you can imagine from every country.
Yeah, no, I didn't know that they had beer in there. I thought it was just wine.
No, they have everything there.
Yeah, now I know why it's called Total Wine and More.
Yeah. But I do not know the name of the beer, and I don't know what it's called, and I'm mad at myself for not finding out. But there was one that tastes like the Smoky Mountains.
You disappoint me.
And it was by far the greatest beer I've ever put on my lips in my life. Like, I've only had one beer that I've rated a 5 out of 5 on, and that was it.
This beer is damn close, okay? I give it a nice solid 4, just because it's not, you know, heavy on the alcohol content. I feel like a 5 would have to be a solid, like, 6% at least for me to give it a 5.
And then, so, everybody knows that I'm a big New Belgium guy, apparently.
Yeah, big booby guy.
I got my New Belgium or my Voodoo Ranger cup here. That's because this week I'm drinking a Voodoo Ranger. How about that? It's actually a Voodoo Ranger I had not had before. It is the Hop Avenger IPA.
Very nice.
A little superhero. Awesome.
Hell yeah.
Action figure.
Little Funko Pop.
Yeah. So there's a new hero in town, and it's the Voodoo Ranger. The beer has a juicy tropical aroma and light sweetness. The IPA packs a powerful pineapple punch.
Okay. I can definitely get down with that. I already like Voodoo Ranger, so that's one that checks my list. Pineapple, 2 and 3. Juicy tropical. Okay.
Dude, it's got that sweet pineapple aftertaste. I love it.
That is something I cannot complain about right there. I'm going to have to go try that.
I've also got another one that I haven't tried yet. It's called the Voodoo Ranger Experimental IPA.
Okay. I think I've had that one. I don't think I've had the Hop Avenger. Well, is that new?
Well, this one's a new one. They just came out with this one.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think they just came out with that.
Because I bought the Voodoo Ranger packs a bunch of times, and this has never been in it.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. I figured that was new. Maybe it's a seasonal one, you think?
Or maybe it's just
a new one they might have released.
But I think it's pretty good.
They have another one that's called the Future Hop. I don't know if you've seen that one.
I saw that one. Actually, I've got one can of this other one. It's called the Voodoo Ranger. It's called like the Dynamite IPA. Mm. But
I don't think I've had that one yet.
That one is actually pretty good. I think that one has like a lemon lime.
Okay. Very nice.
I have to check.
So you bought the variety pack.
Yeah, this one has the Voodoo Ranger IPA, Voodoo Ranger Juicy Hazy IPA, the Avenger, and then the Experimental.
Okay, so what do you give her on a 1 to 5 scale? One,
I give this one a 3.75.
A 3.75. Is 3. That even legal?
Yes.
Okay.
We can go by 0.25s.
We can go by the quarters? Okay.
Yeah, we can go by the quarters.
Very nice. I like it. All right. I'm definitely going to try that then.
It's not the best IPA I've ever had, but it's damn good.
Okay. What's the alcohol percentage?
I actually have no idea.
Yeah, I mean, it's a new beer, so I don't really
know. Oh, shit. It's 7.7%.
What? What? Oh, I'm on the way to the store after this podcast is done getting that. Understand?
Yeah, because the Experimental is only 6.6.
Wow. That sounds delicious. He said it has a little pineapple aftertone, 7.7%.
Taste the alcohol.
That might be 4.25 for me.
Dude, you drink a couple of these, boy, it puts you on your ass.
Not on my ass. I'll be sitting there on the pong table.
I feel like this podcast is just an excuse so we can drink at night.
I mean, anybody that's listening to this could find an excuse and say, yeah, honey, I'm going to go listen to the podcast, you know, and have a beer, relax.
Pretty much.
It's a good excuse.
Because there's been more more than a couple times on here that I've been a little drunk.
We release on Wednesdays, so that's that you can listen to us on Wednesdays. There's no sports going on, you know. You can have an excuse to drink on a Wednesday, and then you can listen to us on a nice little Friday if you ain't catched up. God, it's just an excuse.
Just a podcast where we can have fun and watch us. And if you watch it on YouTube, you can just watch us get drunk.
Yeah, slowly and slowly, you know.
Slowly, as we get to the last segments, our speech starts getting a little impaired,
and then we just start rambling and just go off topic. But so we're gonna go ahead and move on. You want to move on to Did You Know?
Yep.
Yes, yes, yes.
All right. Did you know? I actually did not know this.
I didn't either.
Yeah, this kind of caught me by surprise. I was searching like random fun facts.
Oh, I thought you were about to say you were searching the web on XXX.
Yeah, I mean, I was. It was for research purposes. What they did in the video was, I took notes on it. It was awesome.
I took notes.
He
has the data recorded. It's okay.
But did you know you're more likely to get a computer virus from visiting religious sites than porn sites?
Do what?
Yeah.
Tell me how.
So, according to the research from the security firm Symantec.
Yeah.
I can't speak. Religious websites carry 3 times more malware threats than pornography sites. Symantec found that the average number of security threats on religious sites was around 115 compared to adult content sites, which carry around 25. In fact, only 2.4% of adult sites were infected with malware. The researchers hypothesized that because porn sites need to generate a profit, there's a financial incentive to keep them virus-free to encourage repeat businesses.
How the fuck? How does that even work?
I don't even know the last time I've been on a church website.
So what happens if you go to, like, Christian Mingle?
I don't know. Does that count as a religious website? I guess. I don't know. I'm just imagining it, like, clicking on my church's website, and the next thing you know, oh, your computer's got AIDS.
It's got AIDS. Oh, goodness.
Nothing we can do about it. Uncurable.
It's uncurable. We don't have a cure for that yet. We're going to have to get a research program funded for that.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. That's great. I did not know that. I wonder if anyone else knew that.
Oh
my goodness.
I'm sure Alan's gonna be in my office going, oh my gosh, no way.
Oh, I bet Alan's gonna be pissed. We're gonna lose a listener tonight.
Nah, bro, he's love it.
If we don't do as we're told.
Oh yeah, dude. We gotta talk about his request later on.
Oh man, but yes, sir.
Moving on.
Today. Today in history.
All right. What's going on today in history, Jeremy?
All right. Today on our release, November 10th, back in 1776, the United States Marine Corps was founded. That's pretty dope.
Is pretty
go America. Go America.
America.
As well as back in 1969, Sesame Street, known for its Muppets character, created by late Jimmy, or no, not Jimmy, Jim Henson, makes a debut on PBS. It's one of the longest running U.S. television shows in history. It's been running for 52 years.
Yeah, it still comes on.
Yeah. It's syndicated worldwide because of its mix of education and entertainment. But did you know, fun fact, you know the longest show ever to air on TV is The Tonight Show?
Wait, really? With Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah, well, it's had, obviously. Well,
it's had somebody before him.
Yeah. It's been running for 67 years.
I did not know that. I figured it would have been like South. No, The Young and the Restless.
No, actually, General Hospital, Days of Our Lives, The Simpsons, and like two other weird ass shows that I've ever heard of. Doctor Who's actually one of them too. Yep, top 10 of the longest shows. I think they all run for more than 50 years, dude.
Ridiculous. Because Doctor Who like started in the 60s.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
They keep it going. I've never actually watched Doctor Who. I knew a girl that was like real into it, but
I've never watched it either.
Apparently, not that much of an oldie. Apparently, after a couple seasons, they change who the doctor is, or they transform into another person. I don't know. It's weird.
What? Doctor Who? I don't know.
Yeah, I don't. I don't know much about that.
But
holidays.
Yeah.
We're doing holidays now. Today is National Area Code Day. So 919, baby.
Shout out.
Forget Me Not Day.
Forget Me Not. You know, I've seen a street sign that said that.
You saw that a street sign that said Forget Me Not.
That was the name of the street.
That sounds a little
A little sus, right? Like wrong, like left, wrong turn three or some shit.
Yeah, that seems a little clingy. National Vanilla Cupcake Day. Sesame Street Day, of course.
That's ironic as hell.
International Accounting Day.
Shout out to the accountants.
Yeah.
Get us paid.
That's it. I love the accountant at our work. She's awesome.
I do not like my accountants.
She gets me my checks. She gets me paid.
That's about all they do. They barely do that. Yeah.
What are your work?
Yeah. They don't be getting my mileage right.
My accountant lady's also our HR lady.
Facts. I think I have a separate HR department.
Well, we don't have very many HR incidents. It's not like we can have sexual misconduct since there's only like two women that work for the company.
Oh, I bet you can with Alan and your boss, David.
Y'all
got a little love triangle going.
It's more of me and Walker at my work.
Oh, God.
We're always threatening to kill ourselves.
Jesus. He said, hey, I'll kill you if you kill me.
Yeah, that's literally exactly how it goes.
Oh, my God. Oh, man. But like, moving on.
I'll be like, I'll kill you. And he'll be like, dude, please do. That way I don't have to do this crap. And I'm like,
oh, man. That's great. No. Let's finish out the day. We'll go home. You know, maybe tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow.
Moving on though to welcome to the sports zone.
You.
Yes. What are we talking about first, Christian?
I don't know. I'm getting pretty good with these things.
With these intros, yeah. Like I said last week, if you guys aren't checking us out on YouTube, if you're just listening to us, check us out on YouTube. Show us some love. Give us those views, those likes, comments.
Yeah. There's one comment. Somebody told us that we need to keep the things that rotate in the bottom. That way, if they stop and pick up, they know where they're at.
Yeah.
In the video, which seems fair.
Yeah. That's pretty smart.
But the number one thing that we are going to talk about in the sports zone is this logo right here. Wow, it was not supposed to come out like that.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's big, it's beautiful, bold, and it's clear.
It was the background was supposed to be transparent.
Oh, no. Fuck that.
We'll put it back up. Look at that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Gorgeous. Go Braves. what, after 26 years, 27 years?
The last time they won was 1995. So 27 years, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, shout out the Braves. I mean, I'm a Mets fan by heart, diehard Mets fan. But, you know, they're divisional rivals, you know, and all that. But shout out the Braves. They deserved it. Screw the Astros.
Dude, apparently there were only a matter of three states that went for the Houston. Texas, Delaware. I don't even know why Delaware.
I guess everybody from Texas moved to Delaware.
I don't know. Texas, Delaware, and then I think it was Louisiana.
Louisiana, sure.
But everybody else in the United States.
Yeah, I saw
Brave Nation, baby.
I saw a double decker bus that was completely full of people, and it was like North Carolinians hopping on the Braves bandwagon. And I was like, you ain't lying, they didn't even got a professional team to root for.
Pretty much.
Oh, I man. Mean,
the Braves are the closest professional team to us.
Yeah, North Carolina, I mean, definitely.
We're not going to go for the damn team. Orioles.
God, no. I was pulling for the Braves once they made it to the playoffs. I was like, go Braves. Go Braves.
I've been going for them since I was like
four. That was the greatest comeback story. I mean, they beat a team that had won, what, 108 games? 106 games?
Something like that.
That's ridiculous. They had like the most wins.
Well, they knocked out the Dodgers, who were going to be the main World Series contenders.
That's what I'm saying. The Dodgers, exactly. The Dodgers and the Astros had the most wins out of anybody, I think, that were in the playoffs, like 100 plus games, and they beat them.
Which, if the Dodgers would have made it into the World Series, this would have been the third World Series they would have been in a row.
Really? Oh yeah, they lost one.
Yeah, they won. I guess they won last year's and they lost the year before.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't know.
But let's go ahead and dive into college football, Christian. Who's
all right, college football. This weekend, UNC is at number 25, Pittsburgh.
Yeah. I think I'm going to go for UNC, dude. They upset Wake Forest last week, man. That was a good game.
Dude, I look at Wake Forest's schedule. They have not played anybody.
Yeah,
They have not played one ranked team.
Yeah, it's been happening a lot with these like teams that are undefeated and shit. I've noticed in the ACC.
Like at least it. Yeah, I don't think Wake Forest is a top 10 contender.
But no, they were. Yeah, there's a lot of, you know, overranked teams, overrated.
Yeah,
we need to get a stamp on here that just goes overrated and just stamps over.
But I'm going for Pitt just because I don't like UNC.
I don't like UNC either. But for betting purposes, I might go UNC just because they went off that. They
Sam
might be a
Howell
little
choke. I'm calling it. Juggling.
I like it. I like it.
Then you got number 19 NC State playing number 9 Wake Forest. I don't know how they're still freaking number 9, but they are.
Yeah, me neither. I'm going for NC State. Like you said, Wake Forest is overrated. NC State beat Florida State last week with fucking 4 touchdowns.
Actually, I looked at the you know how if you go on like the ESPN app, it'll show you like the percentage that they think who's going to win.
Right.
State actually has a higher percentage than Wake Forest.
That's great. I love
like
to see 56% it.
56% chance of winning, I guess you could say.
I love to see it. I love to see it.
Yeah, so I'm actually pretty excited for that game. Then you got number 14, Texas A&M versus number 16, Ole Miss.
Yes, sir. That's going to be a really good game. That's why I put this up here to mention it. I feel like this is going to be a shootout, like a 50-some game.
I like Texas A&M.
Yeah,
Ever since they beat Alabama, they've been rolling, son.
Yeah, Texas I feel like might have it. Yeah, definitely. They've gotten past the Johnny Manziel age.
Going back to this past week, did you see where was it? Michigan State, is that who it was? Lost.
Oh yeah, yep.
Number 3 overall, lost to Purdue.
Yep. Let's see here. I'm looking right now.
It's okay while you look that up. And give a review.
Yeah, they did. Purdue whooped that ass 40-29.
Was it Michigan State?
Yep.
Okay.
It was Michigan State.
Yeah, Purdue was like 4-4.
Yeah, they are. Oh, man.
Dude, yeah. Did you watch that game? That was a freaking good game.
I didn't. I only watched the highlights.
Oh, they played their damn hearts out. It was awesome.
Yeah. Another good notable game, I'd say, would be Oklahoma and Baylor is going to be playing this week at noon. That's going to be a really good game. Baylor's ranked 12th, Oklahoma 8th. Cheers, bud.
Yeah, buddy.
But yeah, we can go ahead and move on to some notable MMA fights that happened this past week. I know you guys, I don't know if you watched the Usman fight. That was a great fight.
I did, and I heard about it though.
Oh yeah, the main fight was fire. There's this kid, man, he's like a Irish kid. He was fucking.
Are you talking about the kid that has his bangs cut straight across?
No. He's a Netherlands.
Oh.
He's a Netherlands guy. Yeah, no, he's not the guy that I'm talking about. This guy was an Ireland dude. He got a one knockout with like a right hook, and it was beautiful. And it was really nice. But Rose had another good knockout too. That was another, or not knockout. That was a good decision fight that went to the end. I can't believe she was the underdog.
Nice. Nice.
You need to watch some of these fights sometime.
Dude, the last, I guess, quote-unquote MMA fight that – well, I guess it wasn't even MMA. It was boxing. It was the Floyd Mayweather versus McGregor.
I'm dead.
That was the last fight I've watched.
Oh, man. Canelo had a great knockout this past weekend. I know our listeners saw that. Oof, what a great fight there. But that Ireland kid, he's 8-0. His name's Gary. He was playing in the early prelims. You guys remember that name? All right, Gary.
Gary.
Yeah, he's gonna show up in some of the higher fights later on. But moving on to the NFL.
Hold on, before we move on to that, I gotta give a big shout out because the NASCAR Cup Series Championship was this weekend. And the winner of that was this cracker right here. Oh, that is a horrible picture.
The winner of that is this cracker right here.
Yeah, Kyle Larson was the winner of that. And second was Truex Jr. And then Hamlin is third.
Shout out.
So Larson was driving number 5 Chevy. Shout out to Chevy.
That's for you, Alan.
Yeah, that was for Alan. Because he's going to stop listening to the podcast if we didn't shout out NASCAR.
Oh, yeah. If anybody else wants anything else shouted out on here, let us know. We got you. But going ahead and diving into the NFL this upcoming weekend. Hype. It's going to be a couple good games. After what happened this past weekend, dude, the Bills losing to the freaking Jaguars 9-6. What? Oh my goodness, man. What in the world? What
is football? Josh Allen was eating Josh Allen.
Oh my goodness. That's the first time that's happened in NFL history. You know that?
Well, no. So it was the first time since like 1985 that a player with the same name has sacked a player with the same name.
No, that was the first time ever.
Hold on. I got the stat.
And you know, he strip fumbled him as well and recovered the fumble.
Yes.
And then he also picked him off.
Josh Allen threw 2 interceptions and had a fumble.
Ridiculous. But diving on into tomorrow night's game, Thursday night, we got the Ravens and the Dolphins.
I got it right here, real quick. Josh Allen is the first player to sack a QB with the exact same listed name since sacks became official in 1982.
That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Well, we got Ravens and Dolphins. Who you got? I think it's going to be a good game. Yeah, for betting standpoint, I'm going to go with the Ravens just for safe bet because I think they're going to start going on a little rolling streak here.
If you go safe, that's not how you win the money.
But yeah. But you just find out my later picks here, okay?
Because okay. All right.
Yeah, Thursday Falcons night.
Falcons versus Cowboys.
I got the Falcons.
Dude, I know Cowboys got blown out.
Dude, they got blown out. They were shut out for the first three quarters, I believe, or something like, or at least halftime.
Yeah, they didn't score till the fourth quarter this past week.
It was like 30-16. Ridiculous. I got the Falcons.
Yeah, I flipped that game and it was like 30-0. I was like, Jesus, I'm glad I didn't play Dak.
Right? So upset I didn't play Herbert. That was the biggest mistake I made. I'd be winning right now in fantasy.
The running back?
No, Herbert.
Oh, are you? For the Chargers?
Yeah, quarterback.
No, I think there's a running back with like the same last name.
I'm pretty sure there is. We got Saints and Titans.
Titans.
Yeah, I like the Titans. Even though the Saints are a bigger contender than I thought. They're a bigger problem than I thought they were going to be. Because they beat the Bucks. Like, but they lost to the Atlanta Falcons.
Dude, the like, Saints are such an off and on team. It's
ridiculous. That's what I'm saying. Like, they could be a problem though for like, you know, so they could win important games for other teams and shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
What happened to Tyson Hill?
I think he got injured. I think he was just out for like an ankle injury or something like that.
Is that what? Because they have Trevor Siemian in as the quarterback and.
Yeah, Hill was injured, I believe.
First Jameson, now Hill. Okay. All
right. They're cursed. So we got the Titans on that one. What's who you got? Jaguars at Colts.
Jaguars are hot right now. I'm going Jaguars.
I'm fucking dead. He said they're hot right now. You got what? One W, two W's? Oh my God!
That's all it takes.
That's all it is. They're on a steamboat now, baby. They're on a roll.
Oh, they're rolling, son.
Nah, dude. The Colts are a problem, man. If they utilize their running game a lot more, I know Taylor already like rushes for two touchdowns every game. But if they use Naheem and they use like you know they just keep running the ball and running the ball, I feel like they could be a problem.
Well, this past week they had like 260 yards rushing or some crap.
Yeah, ridiculous. Yeah, they did.
Yeah, they were running the lights out, but
yeah. No, I got the Colts.
I didn't see how severe Trevor Lawrence's injury was.
He came back in the game.
Did he?
Yeah, he just went out with a little ankle roll. You know, he came back in.
I didn't.
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't watch the end of the game. I never watched the end of the game. Browns versus Patriots.
I got the Patriots.
My boy Baker was rolling today, son.
The Patriots, they're a sleeper team. They're a little creeping up on the division.
No, just because they beat the Panthers doesn't mean they're good.
I know, but the Browns, they're shitty.
They're what?
They're shitty. You heard me.
No.
The Browns are shit.
I don't know. I think now that they got Odell out of their hair, they can finally get to playing some football.
Odell's about to go to the Patriots and play against the Browns next weekend.
I heard he might go to the Saints.
Dude, if he goes to the Saints, that is not a good move. I heard he's trying to go to a team, like a playoff contending team.
Yeah, he said that he's not – he said he's going to sign with a playoff contending team, he said.
Yeah. I don't blame him. It needs to be if he's going to be catching balls.
He's like KD signing with the Warriors.
Yeah.
He's just there to win something and leave.
Yeah, should have stayed with the Giants. They could have had real chemistry there.
No, the Giants are never going to make it past the first round of the playoffs.
That's the Panthers you're talking about. You mispronounced Panthers.
First of all, the Panthers aren't even making the playoffs this year.
Exactly. At least the Giants can make the playoffs.
Yeah, Sam Darnold needs to retire.
We got the Bills and the Jets, all right? I got the Bills all day, even though they lost terribly. They're going to come out steaming. I'm talking fucking light under their ass.
If White's the quarterback, Jets all day, baby.
Jesus.
It is hilarious to me that every freaking quarterback has thrived. Every backup quarterback has thrived under the Jets offense except Zach Wilson. Is that his name?
Yeah. That is great. We got the Lions and the Steelers.
Lions.
I got the Steelers.
Not Lions. I forgot.
What are you, drunk?
Yeah.
What are you, drunk?
You know what? Actually, I'm going Lions.
Yeah, he's drunk, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I'm going Steelers. We got the Bucks and Washington football team. I'm going Bucks.
Bucks.
We got Panthers and Cards.
Cards.
Damn, you're betting against your own team?
Dude, Sheesh. They suck.
Sheesh. Yeah, I'm going Cardinals too. We got the Vikings and the Chargers.
Vikings.
I got the Chargers. That's going to be a good game. Eagles and Broncos.
Broncos.
Broncos. Okay. I like it. I'm going to go Broncos too. I like it. Seahawks and Packers. Dang. Is Russell Wilson going to be back this week?
I don't know. It also depends if Aaron Rodgers is going to be back.
He should be.
I don't know. They're talking about suspending him because he's not vaccinated.
True. Packers. I got the Packers.
Well, I got Packers if Rodgers is coming back. I got Seahawks if they don't.
Okay. I like it. We got the Chiefs and the Raiders for Sunday Night Football. That's going to be a really good game, even though they lost to the Giants.
Chiefs.
I got the Raiders. Chiefs are dog water. Okay. We got the Rams and the 49ers for Monday Night Football.
Rams.
The Rams. I got the 49ers.
That's a bad.
I think the Rams are overrated.
I don't think so.
I think the Rams are overrated.
They just got Von Miller.
The Rams are overrated. The Rams are overrated. Von Miller is not overrated. The Rams are overrated.
Yeah.
Okay.
All I'm saying is they're going to have one hell of a defense.
Yeah, they are. They are, definitely.
Well, more of like a pass. They're going to have one hell of a pass rush.
I would hate, and I mean, I would hate to be an inside slot receiver.
You better hope you got a solid O-line.
Every time I try to catch the ball down low and just go down immediately, just be like, oh, God.
I wouldn't even be that worried if I was a receiver. I'd be worried if I was the quarterback.
I'd be worried if I was the running back.
Dude, well, yeah, that too. Because, I mean, if you don't have a good O-line, you are just fucked.
Yeah, you want to talk about the Rams being overrated? They just got pick six.
Wait, who threw that? Stafford threw the pick six?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Fuck.
It's not what I needed.
Well, I guess we can go ahead and move on to news of the week.
Yes, we can.
For a new broom.
So, Jeremy, you use condoms?
What?
Yep.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Well, I got a new condom that's perfect for you, baby.
For me? No. Last week we talked about you being part of the Smong Dong community.
No, I was just supporting a.
Oh, you're a big donor? Is that what you are?
I was in support that they shouldn't get made fun of for having small dongs. I mean, when you've got like a forearm in your pants, I mean.
I think we can go back and check your receipts and talk about how you said you were barely bigger than a gorilla.
Dude, I make
a... Receipts.
That was just me being funny. a Malaysian gynecologist has come out with... has come out with a new condom. It's a sticky condom. It's called the Wonderleaf Unisex Condom. It's for men and females.
Oh God! What in the hell?
I didn't read intensely on how this thing works, but apparently,
you can.
You can slap this bad boy on when you're soft, and you can grow to a little bit larger whenever he takes the shirt off. Huh?
So where it forms to it, nice and comfy like a glove.
I guess.
So instead of this, it's more like this.
Yeah, apparently the reason this guy created this is because he was tired of seeing like teenage girls get pregnant because the condom slipped off. Apparently, so he made a condom that does not slip off. It has an adhesive in it.
That is great.
Boy, that thing sticks.
Small dong community can rejoice.
Dude, and it's unisex, so I don't know if it's got like a packer or whatnot, but yeah, you can put it in your girl's vagina, and it sticks to the outline of her vagina, so whenever you get in there, it's almost like you're fucking a plastic bag.
My God. Oh, geez, that is not good.
So there's that.
Oh, goodness. I can't breathe. Is it?
you know what they should do?
What?
Like for people with people with tiny penises, like a company should really
come out with. You mean micro penises?
Huh? Micro penises. Well, like anything below like, what's the word I'm looking for? Anything below ginormous like me. Like if you buy, like, you know, if you go, if somebody goes through and buys like the small condoms, they don't want to go through the checkout because it's a little embarrassing.
It's right.
Embarrassing. I mean, they should come out with like a branding, like Gorilla Dick or something.
Gorilla Dick.
I mean, because not many people know that gorillas have a very tiny dick. So you roll up to the checkout with that box in your hand. You got to put it in an oversized box
first. And they're just sitting here like, damn, son, where'd you find this?
You got to put it in an oversized box, first of all, the condoms. And it's got to have like big platinum letters and whatnot. And, so you roll up with that big meaty box.
Oh, and, my God.
You hand it to the cashier. She looks like – she just looks at you. She's like, oh, you got a gorilla dick.
Oh, God.
And you're just like, yeah, I do.
Little does she know.
All 2 inches of it, baby.
That ain't good at all.
Oh.
Oh, my God. But moving on.
This condom apparently sticks to your dong. I wonder how that works after you come. You just like run around with like a water balloon.
Probably running around.
Like, the only thing I can imagine is like a water balloon stuck on the faucet.
That's exactly what it is. And you got to peel it off to get it off because it's stuck. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, boy.
But moving on and speaking of stuck together, a Minnesota police officer was summoned to break up an unusual street fight when two bald eagles were found stuck together in the middle of the road. The officer told... Yeah. So apparently he got called up. And there was these two bald eagles. They were in the middle of a fight, apparently, and they got clawed up together, and they got tangled up, and they got stuck. And he got called up and to go basically take care of it. And he basically said, we do have de-escalation tactics, but never applied them to eagles or other animals. The eagles started going at it again, and the next thing you knew, they flew away. He told the reporter after, after he broke up the fight. He said apparently they started going back at it again and they just flew away.
I can't imagine like stepping in between like two bald eagles.
Oh my God, I'd be terrified, dude. Imagine being an officer getting called to take care of two bald eagles in the middle of a street. I'd be like, I don't get paid enough for this. I'm going to call
it's not control. Like you could pull your gun out and shoot one of them either because it's a protected species.
That's a federal crime. Yes, yeah. Sir. Oh, God.
Like, I read a story about a dude who, like, had, like, a bald eagle mounted in his apartment, and the police came in for, like a something that wasn't even related to it, and they're like, yo.
Oh, no.
No.
They were just like, that's not okay.
Not cool, dude.
That's not cool. Damn.
Here's a felony charge.
Caught 4K.
So, moral of the story is, don't mount a bald eagle in your house.
Don't kill a bald eagle.
That too.
Yeah. But speaking of animals, a school in Saskatchewan, Canada.
Saskatchewan.
Yeah, what he said. They experienced an unusual interruption when a moose ran through a large glass window and crashed into a classroom. Witnesses say they were dropping off their two-year-old off at the daycare when they started recording, and they watched this moose just crash right into the classroom just across the hall. It was crazy. This is the most Canadian thing you can think of.
Dude, have you seen how big a freaking moose is?
Oh, dude, they're like 7 to 10 foot tall, aren't they?
Dude, they're freaking massive.
Like, oh, absolutely.
Like, they would fuck me up.
Yeah, it's not an animal I could take on barehanded.
Here, let me roll this clip. I hadn't watched it, but.
Good evening. We begin tonight with a scary incident at a Saskatoon school this morning. A moose smashed through a window of a room where children were being cared for.
Saskatoon.
No one was seriously injured, but as Nicole DiDonato tells us, it was a close call that has left a community rattled. It was a wild morning in the Evergreen neighborhood Thursday after a moose broke through a glass window in the community entrance of Sylvia Fedorov and St. Nicholas Catholic School. There's a little concern at first, just not knowing if there was kids in there or how it got in. Ashley Young was dropping off her kids who were in grades 1 and 3 at Sylvia Fedorov School when she discovered what happened.
As we came across the front entrance, my youngest yells, "Mom, there's a moose in the school." And of course, I didn't believe him. Certainly not something that you would see every day.
Yeah, what the hell?
The moose entered a room where children were taking part in a before school program.
You think he was lying?
By BBC's hospital.
Right.
It says there were two staff and what, possibly 15 Chick-fil-A kids cow? Between the ages of 5 and 12 in the room at
Mom,
the time.
Mom, there's a moose.
Staff helped the children safely get out.
Stop
by
lying, kid.
Through the window the moose crashed through. That's because the moose was blocking the other exit.
They were so brave and courageous, and they put those kids' needs first. I think that this could have been so much worse. This actually is a very serious situation. We were so lucky to have everybody come out of this okay.
No injuries were reported. Dude, aside I would have loved to see a kid try to ride as a result thing. Of climbing through the smashed window. Saskatoon police received a call about the incident just before 9:30
God,
morning.
Oh God, he's got a little 6-year old trying to ride a moose. My
the moose was then tranquilized and successfully released back into the wild.
Look at that
Although
thing.
Although seeing
so
moose
cute.
In the city isn't an everyday
nice.
Occurrence,
that's a baby
an
moose.
With the
that's a happy ending there.
Says it's not entirely uncommon.
Hopefully they find their way out of the city and this
not uncommon. Okay, so this is a regular thing in Canada. All right, understood.
Some pets and some dogs that caused the problem, and the moose started running and ended up in this area at the school where it obviously panicked and went through a glass window.
We're told the daycare was let out for the day, but
a glass
classes
window.
At both elementary schools remained in session. Nicole As for the before DiDonato. And after school program, it will be closed until Monday. Nicole DiDonato, CTV News, Saskatoon.
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 That's what it's called.
What
Saskatoon.
The hell did you just say?
All right. Well, now we know how to say Saskatoon.
Right. That's still the most Canadian thing I've ever seen in my life. A moose running through a window into a classroom. Oh,
that's pretty
God.
Funny.
That is awesome.
Dude, I would have paid money for that to happen when I was in middle school or elementary.
Right? You get to go home early. Mom, why are you so home so early? That's,
dude, you get to see, it's like the damn zoo. You get to see a moose and you get to go home early.
Man, you know how many people would try to ride that thing if that happened in our school, in high school?
Dude.
We've been taking so many turns.
I got so many people in mind that would try to ride it.
I'm one of them.
I know, I am too.
Oh, God.
The weird thing is, I specifically remember, like, whenever I was, like, 5 years old, we had a black lab. And it snowed, and I specifically remember trying to ride his ass through the snow.
Trying to ride his ass. Oh, yeah, that poor dog. Oh, man.
Pretty much.
But a Missouri man actually said, you know, they were driving home, you know, from wherever they were coming from. And his wife insisted to, stop by and buy a lottery ticket. And, you know, he was trying to get home so he could watch that football game, man. He really wanted to get home. And she just kept insisting. Ooh, I've had that one. That one's really tasty.
The juicy?
Yeah, the juicy. Yeah, juicy haze is a good one. And so they were just, you know, on the way home, and she just kept insisting, buy a lottery ticket. So out of frustration, he stopped, pulled over at this gas station, bought a lottery ticket. And guess what happened when they got home?
I'm assuming they won.
They fucking won $2.4 million jackpot. And his wife forced him to pull over and buy that lottery ticket. And he was wanting to get home and watch football, but
he's going to use that in every argument.
Until the day he dies.
Ever.
He can't live that down. And honestly, I probably would start listening to her at that point.
Dude, he's going to be like, honey, I'm going out with the boys. No, you ain't.
Why? Oh, my God.
The time I told you about that lottery ticket?
Oh, my God. And we won $2.4 million? Yeah. Yeah. Get to scrubbing the dishes.
You're dishwashing now, bitch.
Oh, my God. I can't believe that. Apparently, they won the drawing on October 23rd out there in Missouri. And the ticket matched all six numbers drawings, 8, 10, 13, 22, 25, and 29. What are the odds? That right there is God telling him, hey, you better start listening to your wife.
Dude, for real.
Oh, my goodness. I've never.
Caitlin better start spitting out some numbers for me.
Right? Hey, Sarah, chop, chop. I need lottery numbers.
That'd be hilarious. Now. Can't ever smack you.
Just boot right what in the back. Alive. Oh, God.
Oh, we got a hernia.
Oh, no. Not again.
I laughed and it hurt.
But moving on to the conspiracy corner. What you got for us this week, Christian?
I'm typing this one thing out, but
where are you?
You know about the secret chamber in Mount Rushmore?
I did not. I did a little research on it, and I saw what it was, but I'd never heard of it before today, actually.
So for anyone that's watching, there's a photo. There's if you look right above, what is that, Lincoln's head to the right?
I believe so.
You can see the doorway to it.
Yeah, you can. Clear as day.
Yeah.
No Photoshop.
You can see the doorway to it. That's real. So there's a hidden chamber behind Lincoln's head. The sculptor Gutzon Borgholm created a 18-foot door behind the landmark that leads to an open room that is 74 feet long and 35 feet high. Borgholm intended to place America's prized possessions in this room. It was supposed to be called the Hall of Records. So,
sus. Very sus.
Yeah, so apparently on the walls, there's like like they carved in like the Declaration of Independence and stuff like that. Very American rim. Also, this guy was like French.
Makes sense. You know, the French gave us the Statue of Liberty.
Yeah, so the French have given us everything. wasn't even an American guy that carved it, but who am I to judge?
Yeah. Hey, there's still people that thought the Mount Rushmore was natural.
Yeah, God put these presidents' faces right on this mountain because they were great. What happened? God's work. So some believe the government is hiding something incredibly secretive because they've got it closed off now. They won't.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And have to.
That would be awesome.
Let's take a trip. Unofficial boys go live into Mount Rushmore head.
People believe that there's proof of extraterrestrial beings in this room. Others believe they're hiding hidden treasures in the room, an idea explored in Nicolas Cage's National Treasure. So
yeah, okay. I think the aliens might be a stretch, but I do believe
there's probably some national treasures. Yeah, I do think the alien thing is kind of a stretch, but I
believe the alien thing is a stretch for the location that they're saying. I think aliens are locked up in Area 51. Not Lincoln's Head. Lincoln's Head probably has a bunch of I think all of the actual art and everything that you see in the Smithsonian and all those museums and stuff, I think all that shit is copies and they just keep the real shit back there.
That was actually one conspiracy, that the actual Declaration of Independence and all of America's original documents are actually locked in this room.
I believe it is.
Everything that's on display at the Smithsonian yada 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 museum is a copy.
Right. Fake. Yep. Smithsonian, the what's the other one? The DC one, the one that's in Philadelphia, the one that was in the National Treasure movie.
Bruh, it's been so long since I've seen that movie.
I know, it's such a good movie though. One of Nicolas Cage's best movies.
Kind of made me want to rewatch it though.
Oh, I definitely have to rewatch it. A little refresh on history, you know.
Yeah. The funny thing is that a lot of stuff in that movie was actually historically accurate.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But did you know that there's a little conspiracy that where all of these Mattress Firm stores in Illinois are within a few miles of each other?
This is not the first time I've heard of this conspiracy.
Yeah, I Google searched this myself and looked up Mattress Firms in Illinois, and this is ridiculous how many. There's literally like 20 of them within a couple of miles of each other.
I actually got locations from Dallas, Illinois, New York, and Atlanta.
What?
So here's Dallas. This is all the locations. There's like 30 in like a 10-mile radius.
What?
Then you've got Illinois. You got like 30 within a 10-mile radius.
No fuck.
Then you've got New York. You've got,
oh my god,
like 20 in a 10-mile radius.
All right.
And you've got Atlanta. They've got like 20 in like a 20-mile radius.
Again, if you're listening, you need to check out our YouTube so that way you can see these pictures, because this is photo evidence of what leads a lot to believe that this is a money laundering business. Mattress Firm is a money laundering business. They have all of these shops set up just to launder money for whatever the hell they're doing.
I don't even know anybody who's even been in a Mattress Firm.
I've been in a Mattress Firm, and there's literally only one employee that works there. They literally work, I think, 10-hour shifts, he told me. Dude. And they switch off.
Sounds pretty That's solid.
It. He opens, Dude. And I'm pretty sure sometimes they close.
Dude, they one can employee. Pretty much just lay on like a Serta mattress all day.
Oh, literally. I would. Shit.
It's got to be a money laundering thing.
But that definitely. I read that, saw that, and I was like, yeah, no, that looks like something sus, man. There's not even that many McDonald's within that much of a radius.
Like, I don't know why, but I think it was my sister that was telling me it had something to do with like dead bodies or something. They were hiding dead bodies in the back or some crap.
Oh God, I hope not. It'd smell.
Yeah. I don't know. That's why whenever you get a mattress, it smells real strong.
I'm dead. It smells so good in there. But another conspiracy I got here that I feel like might kick a little poll here or some comments. So I don't know if anyone has heard about the Denver International Airport is actually twice the size of Manhattan, New York. And almost every corner of this massive transportation
hub. It's twice the size of Manhattan?
Yes, twice the size.
I did not actually know that. Holy shit. Because I've been to – so whenever I went to Dallas's airport, I Googled like the largest airports in the U.S., and uh-huh. Dallas is the second largest airport.
Right.
And Denver was number one. I didn't know Denver was that freaking big. Jesus Christ.
Yeah. They just got open land out there, you know, basically like country. That's crazy, right? Twice the size of Manhattan.
Yeah. But I wasn't expecting that number or statement.
Okay. Yeah. So apparently this airport's full of conspiracy theories, but one that really caught my eye was for starters, the airport was $2 billion over budget. $2 billion. Who the fuck approves that, first off? Okay. Then leads some to believe that it has an underground structure that is either used as bunkers or as headquarters built.
I want to back up for a second because I'm doing a job in Wake Forest right now, mm-hmm. and they're about 100K over budget, and right now the architect is sweating.
Yeah, these guys went $2 billion over budget.
So something...
That's sus, okay? Someone approved something, okay? And so this leads some to believe that the bunkers in the headquarters were built by some neo-Nazis because of the marks and plaques that are left around the airport. And it's said to be funded by the New World Airport Commission.
All right. So this All right, is so
take
this
a is hard your, look at that photo.
This is your airport. So you don't see it right now, but if you pull up a different photo,
boom. Look at that.
Oh,
look
my
at that.
God.
Tell me. Come on. Tell me, that's too much of it. You can see it right there. That's too much of a coincidence, man. There's no coincidences. I don't believe in them. I mean, there's a bunch of plaques too around. That's not the only sign. There's plaques around that literally sponsored the place. That's called the New World Airport Commission. Come on, that is sus. That's a little creepy. I've played. You know what I'm saying? I've played Wolfenstein. I know what the New World Order is.
So I'm going to add to this. So you said previously that there was underground tunnels built all around.
Yes. And for the people who are listening, the runways are basically in the shape of a swastika for the pictures that we showed.
Yeah. It's fine. So there's also another conspiracy theory that this is the actual location that the Illuminati lives or meets.
Yep.
Like I said, it's within plenty. These underground tunnels of the airport.
Freaking people with money, man. They can just do whatever they want. $2 billion over budget. Imagine if we try to make a small little business and we went $2 billion over budget.
We'd be in debt.
We'd be hung by loan sharks, skinned. Our bones would be sold for marrow.
Probably. I wouldn't doubt it. Not for a second.
Oh, my God. But, yeah, no, that swastika stuff got me. I was reading into it, and I was like, okay. I saw some pictures of the plaques and the paintings and the creepy stuff that's hung around the place, like as artwork and stuff. And then I saw the fucking airport layout, and I said, bro, what? That literally looks like a swastika. That's in the shape of a swastika. Why would you put the airport strip in the shape of a swastika?
I'm not going to lie. I would I would like to visit this airport.
Yeah, me too. Let's do it. Let's go take a trip to Denver.
So Denver airport. The key is, so fun fact for anybody listening, buying plane tickets. So the key is, if the flight to wherever your destination is expensive, look for a cheaper destination with a connecting flight with that airport.
Yep. And use Hopper. Shout out Hopper, the app. Hopefully we can get sponsored by those guys. Hopper, the app, will combine your hotel, your air flight, and your, you know, your transportation there too.
What are we doing, ad reads now?
Well, I mean, I've used it personally and it's awesome.
Oh, I see ads for it all the time, but I've never used it.
Oh, I have the app. Yeah, no, you can book your Airbnb and your plane flight and everything through it. It's pretty dope.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm. And so it'll combine it and it'll like bundle it so it's cheaper.
Oh, okay. That's,
yeah, it's very cool. I'm about to do that for a Thanksgiving trip. I'm about to go down to Florida.
All right. So apparently I got to download the Hopper app now.
Yeah.
He said, but yeah, the key for, you know, if you don't use the Hopper app, the key to getting a cheaper flight is to find a connecting flight that's cheaper with the airport that you're looking for, or that you're thinking of arriving in.
Right, right.
You just would not go to the connecting flight. You just stay in the, say if you're flying to Dallas, and Dallas, say from North Carolina to Dallas was $200, and then
North Carolina to Baltimore to Dallas.
Yeah, from North Carolina, or for instance, whenever I went to Oklahoma, from North Carolina to Oklahoma, there's not a connecting flight, so it's North Carolina to Dallas to Oklahoma. That was cheaper than North Carolina to Dallas.
Right. I mean, you got to stay on a plane a little bit longer, you know, enjoy the flight, get some air food.
Yeah, but so.
That's great.
Just fun fact for anybody that flies.
Yeah. Save some money, you know what I'm saying? It's always good. Save some money. Spend it on the actual destination instead of just the travel.
Yeah. All right, moving on. We go on to the flashbacks.
Oh, God, this week's flashbacks.
What we got on this list? Napalm golf balls. Practice on the worst field known to man. It only made it better. And running back in the rain to make baseball game.
Oh, my goodness. So, leading off with the napalm golf balls. You remember that shit, Christian? Me and my man.
This is now going to turn into a lesson.
Yes, yes. This is going to be a science lesson for everybody. So I'll start it off.
Freaking napalm.
I'll start it off with how we just got this board. What were we, like 16? I'd say 15 years old.
We were probably like 15. Yeah, we were probably about that age.
We might have been like 14.
Yeah, we weren't able to drive yet. So, yeah, we were 14 or 15.
No, we were able to drive. I think you had your white Explorer, old girl. I think you had just gotten your license like 15. You were 15. I was like 14 because, you know, you're older than me.
Yeah.
So
I guess there's still a spot. There's still a spot burnt into the asphalt from when we played with napalm that day.
In your cul-de-sac? Oh, yeah. My God. So me and this man, we're probably playing 2K or MLB, you know, bored as hell. And we get this bright idea to go to
the food line. I'm rolling back. It wasn't even our bright idea. Garen.
Oh,
Garen was over. This was Garen's bright idea.
This is factual statements. This is facts.
We're sitting there and we're playing. We're playing like Madden or some shit.
Yeah, we're switching off.
And Garen is like, dude, you want to make some napalm? That piques our interest.
How do we make napalm, you ask?
We played Call of Duty. We've seen it rain from the sky. We want to make some.
We want to make some. Bad.
So we get on the internet and we Google how to make napalm.
Turns out all you need is three things.
And apparently, actually, technically only two.
Yeah, three. Because, you know, you need something to put it in.
Well, yeah, that is true. That is true. So what you need is a bucket, gasoline, and styrofoam.
Yes, preferably a plastic bucket because it won't melt.
So, basically the gasoline will eat the styrofoam and it will turn it into a gel.
Yeah, so basically me and Christian go to Lowe's Foods, right? We pick out this styrofoam cooler. We get some gasoline from the Food Lion gas station, and we get a plastic cup from his cupboard, right? We go outside, we get back, we pour this cup full of gasoline as we're breaking off pieces of the styrofoam from the fucking cooler, and we're shoving it in there. We're just shoving it in there.
Oh my God, it's gone. Another piece in there.
Literally,
oh,
wow. It's just melted, it's gone, and instantly.
Until it's just like a full-blown, like, it's like putty.
Yeah, like, literally like stretchy-ass putty.
Looks like damn Play-Doh.
It's crazy.
Dude, you light that shit on fire. It burns for hours.
Oh, my God, dude. What did we light on first? I have a video. I'm going to have to show this next week or something. I had a video of Garen. We lit a basketball on fire. We put a little bit of napalm on top of a basketball. Yeah, set that bitch on fire.
You ever seen those videos of people putting, like, rubbing alcohol on a basketball and then lighting on fire? Well, this is worse. This thing just keeps burning. It doesn't go out.
It doesn't go out. And Garrett decides to grab a golf club. And he sticks the golf club in the basketball flame where the napalm's coming from. And he's just holding it there. And then, like, after 10 seconds, he pulls it out and he goes, "I lost my head." His golf club head had just melted right off because the flame was so hot. It was the funniest thing. He did not expect it. And we're just sitting there like, holy shit, we got to put that thing out.
Was the cul-de-sac thing, is that where we started?
Because yes, that was where we started. That was a different day.
Yeah, so we start off in the cul-de-sac with this shit. And we just got something and we just kind of like laid it out on the cold, like on the asphalt in the cul-de-sac, and we just lit it on fire and we were like,
just to see what would happen.
Yeah, just to see what would happen. It just burned 5 hours later, burning.
It's still burning.
7 hours later, burning.
It's not going out.
Mad because it's burning. Thing.
Oh my God. Your mom was pissed. Oh my goodness.
She's always pissed.
But so continuing on with this same day. So after Gary loses the head of his golf club in this fire, right? We put the basketball out. We're like, fuck it. We get the other drivers and clubs that we have, and we decide to put a little teeny bit of pea-sized napalm on these golf balls we have. And we tee them up, light them on fire, and the entire golf ball is in flames.
Looking at this now, we could have started a forest fire.
And we decide to tee this ball up that's on fire, and we just drive this sucker straight into the woods. I'm talking 300 yards. And we just start yelling, "Fort!"
Oh, yeah.
Oh, mind you, these golf balls, you can see these golf balls getting sent on fire.
We could have been the reason that North Carolina would look like California right now.
But no, we saw the golf balls went out when they hit the ground. They didn't, because we put so little.
Yeah, we only put like a dot of it, but.
Yeah, that was, oh my God, that was great.
If we
had
smothered one of those motherfuckers and.
Oh, if we just cover the entire thing, bro, it'd probably still be burning to this day.
Yeah, back to the cul-de-sac thing, the first fire we lit with this shit, we burnt a hole in the asphalt of the cul-de-sac.
Forgot about that.
Like, we burnt a hole in the asphalt of the cul-de-sac. It was awesome.
It was awesome. The best accomplishment of our childhood life.
Dude, seriously. I'm wondering why I don't use this shit to light fires in the back.
Yeah, we need to start doing that for bonfires. Just put that on one log, and that thing will be a starter log for fucking 8 hours.
Seriously, no kidding. Just put a little dot on it.
That is great. That's not a bad idea, Christian. We need to patent that. Start making unofficial boys starter logs and just put unofficial napalm.
Boys starter logs includes napalm.
Includes napalm. Non-explosive.
Non-explosive.
Okay, it just burns. It's just non-explosive. Oh, God, that's great.
Just don't release it out of the bottom of a jet that flies by.
Right, yeah. But do you remember practicing on that field over there off of...
Fanny Brown Road.
Fanny Brown Road. Oh, my goodness. And I tell you, if any of our listeners play baseball...
of rocks.
If any of y'all listen to baseball, I know y'all probably had that one field that y'all hated, right? And y'all had that one field that you loved that was just beautiful, soft, the dirt was beautiful. There's a certain dirt that you like. There's a certain grass that you like. You know what I'm saying? Everybody knows. All of our baseball players know. This field had all dirt infield, every rock shape known to man, and the outfield you could call barely grass. You could call that weeds. All right.
That's pretty.
And oh my goodness, literally with my own eyes, I've seen a ball come straight at me as a line drive, as a ground ball, and it hit a rock and go straight to the right toward the third baseman. On God.
Yeah. It made us great infielders. I remember
Craig, if you could feel it on this field, you could feel it on any field.
Which that was that right there is a great point. Like
it was. It made you get down on the ball.
Why buy one of those crazy balls that you throw that jump all over the place for fielding when you could just hit on this field?
Yeah, those things are unrealistic. You know, those balls, that was real reaction time. You had to, you were sitting here ready and had to dive over here.
Somebody hit a ball you 100 miles an hour and it hits a rock, what are you going to do? You better catch it before it hits you in the face.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, man, that's going to have to be another one because first time I moved down here, I got hit right in the nose with a line drive.
Dude, there was one time where I got on the all-star team for Gazel one year. And
we were probably on it at the same time.
Probably. Were you on it when I got hit in the chest that one time?
Oh, God, yeah.
Dude, I was on third base, and I was the guy that was batting just hit a straight up fucking dinger. Holy shit!
You were sitting there.
My ribs were broke. Dude, he hit a ball as hard as I've ever seen, and it hit me straight in the chest on the third base line.
Oh my goodness! I remember that because you had the baseball imprint on your chest.
I thought I was dead.
It had the stitches, you had the laces on it, and the name of the ball imprinted, I'm pretty sure.
I honestly to God thought that I'd broke my rib. He hit it so hard.
You definitely bruised it. You definitely bruised it.
Dude, there was a big ass bruise on my chest, but
oh my God.
Honest to God, I thought I broke my rib with how hard he hit it. And I was in the dugout crying. That shit hurt like hell. I couldn't breathe.
Oh my God. But no, that field was the worst, man. If anybody feels like they have a worse field they played on, let us know the name. Ours was off of Fanny Brown. If anybody lives in Garner, they probably know the field we're talking about.
Did you ever play at ECAP before they redid the field?
I don't think so.
The dirt was brick. Crushed brick.
Bitch, what? That ain't good. That ain't good. That ain't good at all.
At ECAP, dude, I specifically remember sliding into a base, and it ripped my baseball pants, and my whole leg was bloody.
Oh, man. Jeez.
That is the only field. And that was for travel ball.
Oh, dude. I think I probably do remember that field then. I just don't remember the actual name.
It was back when we won that national championship, or not national, the BPA championship.
Oh, when we had Pooper Scooper?
No, he wasn't on there then. It was back when we had Wyatt and a bunch of the other.
Oh, yeah, Kobe.
No, Kobe wasn't on there yet.
Is Trevor there?
Trevor.
Wiley?
Brooks Banks was on there.
I remember that.
It was like when we first started.
Yeah, yeah. That's facts.
Dude, I slid into a base and I was bloody everywhere.
Speaking of those tournaments, remember when we used to go on those walks down the road, right? Remember, I know back on the other episodes we talked about going down to that pond by your house and shit like that, doing some stupid stuff back there. But remember when we kept walking and then we found Sammy's house and we were just like, oh, I've had that one too. That was good. But remember when we kept walking and we found Sammy's house and we were like, wait, isn't this Sammy's neighborhood? Yeah, this is Sammy's house. And we just walked up to this random person's house and knocked on the door. And Sammy home, and he ended up coming to the door and answering.
What are you guys doing here? I don't know. We thought this was your house.
And we were just walking around and wanted to say, hey, he was like, what's up, man? Oh my god. And we were with Garen too, I'm pretty sure. And it started raining when we had to walk back, and your dad was calling us, like calling you back, because like, hey, we're about to leave in like 15 minutes for the game or whatever to head to the tournament.
And we're like sprinting back.
And we're like a 30-minute walk away, and we're sitting there sprinting in the rain. Garen's all the way in the back with his shirt tied around his forehead. You're sitting there with your shirt pulled up over your head, yelling. And I'm in the front just running my ass off trying to get back.
We weren't as quick as you. We had to make do with what we had.
Yeah. That was hilarious. Oh my, it was so worth it though, getting to see Sam.
We should try to get Garen on here.
Oh, getting Garen on here would be great. Or Sammy.
I might married now. They'd be like, hey, you want to be on a podcast?
Yeah, Sammy's on about married now, I'm pretty sure.
Is he? I hadn't talked to Sammy in so long.
I think he posted on Instagram he got married or bought a house or something like that.
What?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Good for them.
Hell yeah. All of our friends are growing up.
I know.
When are you going to buy a house and get married, Christian?
I already bought a house. What are you talking about? When are you going to buy a house?
When's the second part going to happen?
I don't know.
Huh?
I can say both for you. You've been dating your girl longer.
It's okay. Time will come.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's all right. You don't need to bring that up.
That's what I thought. You heard that, Sarah?
Shit.
Yeah, you lucky you got them headphones on.
But we're moving on to what if.
Sorry, I'm drinking. Yeah, I see you looking back. You like, I hope she didn't hear that.
Yeah, no, she heard it. I'm in trouble. I'm getting hit with the firing pan after the episode.
That's what I'm talking about.
That good. Should have been talking shit. Nice. But what if the South won the Civil War, Christian? I'm just going to lead off with that. I'm going to lead off with what if they won?
Well, oddly enough, if the South did win the Civil War, I don't think they would still be slaves.
Really?
No.
That's weird. I'd still think they would be slaves.
Name another country that still has slaves.
Africa.
Fuck. That's not a country. It's a continent.
Okay, South Africa.
That's still not a country.
Okay, Zimbabwe.
Okay, well, that's... America is better than Zimbabwe.
All right, Russia.
Yeah, but we don't know about
that. You know what? No. America, they still have slaves.
Well, yeah.
They still have slaves. Yeah, sex slaves. So fuck off. Yeah. Yeah, they're still... Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. So if the South would have won, they'd be a lot more slaves. That's different. You and me wouldn't be friends, okay?
I'll be on the southern. What do you say, boy?
Honestly, I don't know. I probably, if the South won, I think I try to work my way into the house slave. I try to be as light skinned as
a house slave.
I try to be as light skinned as I could.
You gonna be like what
hey man.
You can be like Samuel Jackson in
Hell yeah, I look good in a suit. They gotta put me in a suit.
You're gonna basically be white except black. You gonna be putting another
what's that nigga doing there on a horse? Samuel Jackson killed that part.
I just remember Django walking down the stairs and it's like all the black folk. He didn't say black folks. He said all the black folks can leave, and then Samuel Jackson trying to walk out there is like, not you, cracker. You know why you staying.
Oh man, that movie is great. Even though it's 3 hours long, it's totally worth all 3 hours.
I've never seen that movie.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, you got to sit her down and tell her to watch that movie. That is great. The part with the hoods when they're like, I can't see fucking shit.
That is the best. That is by far the best scene in movie history.
He said, I can't see fucking shit. He said, my wife worked hard, long and hard on these, and all I hear is criticize.
It was a good idea, but let's just say we do the holes right next time. Where? Don't ask me and my family for nothing. All I hear is criticize.
Oh my god, that is great. Jonah Hill killed that part too.
The dude just putting on the thing and be like, I can't see fucking shit.
That was Jonah Hill. Oh my goodness. Oh man.
And then when they're riding around with a damn mask on, they can't see shit. And they're just blowing up.
They're just blowing up, running for their lives. Oh my goodness. But you never answered my question. What if the South won the Civil War, Christian? What would you do?
Well, first
would
of
you
all,
would you own slaves or would you move to the North?
Well, let's back up a little bit. If the South won, there wouldn't be a North.
I mean, there'd still be a North, you know, but you could still.
There wouldn't be a North, but there wouldn't be like a North North.
Yeah.
And second, I'd be A-okay because I'm a white male.
God, he said he wouldn't do nothing to change it.
Look, when you got the privilege card, you got to take it. That's all I'm saying.
Oh god, I saw this TikTok where this guy was like, hey, that's a cool nickname, what was that? And he's like, oh, so does that mean I get my black card? Oh, okay, cool. He's like, so what you gonna do if a bunch of bunch of homies pull up on you and say, hey bro, get in the car, we're about to go do some shit, what you gonna do then? He goes, he's sitting there, has some nuts in his hand, he goes, you know what, man, I gotta see it through, my boy, I gotta see it through. That shit killed me. I was just like, bruh, this man is tweaking. That had me so weak.
Have you seen the Michael Myers things on TikTok?
Well, I probably like have.
Michael Myers during the off season.
Where he's like working out in the gym.
Oh, there's this dude dressed up as Michael Myers. And he's like, there's only four Michaels you really know of. He's like, got Michael Jordan.
Oh, Michael Jackson, I have seen that. The interview.
Michael Jackson, Michael Phelps, and Michael Myers. During the offseason, I be running. Like, you got to get – when they running down the stairs and they running into the parking deck and you supposed to be right behind them, but you already there?
I have seen that.
That takes cardio.
I have seen that,
bro. Oh dude, I wish I had that video to show everybody. That thing is so funny.
Oh, I've seen that interview. He's like dressed up and shit like a hype beast.
You got Drake playing in the background.
Yeah, that is great. But what if you could change one awful event in history, Christian, but it means you may never have been born? What would that event in history be?
What if I changed an awful bit after I was born?
But it doesn't matter. That awful event that happened could be something that occurred before you were born, so those events still had to change before.
So say if I changed 9/11, which I was like 5 years old at, I'd just disappear?
No, so if you change 9/11, right, let's say that that never happened, right? So let's say something before 9/11 didn't happen as well, because that didn't happen either, you know, because that's all part of some master plan. Why wouldn't that
happen? Because 9/11 didn't happen.
Well, I mean, you tell me, you changed 9/11, right? Well, you changed that awful course in history. This question says, but it means you may never have been born. Well, bro, right?
I watched The Flash. I know how this works.
I've seen The Flash. I know how this works. Oh, that's one multiverse. That's how it works. Okay. All right. I know how The Flash works. Don't get it twisted.
I know how this works.
Oh man. If I could change one event, it'd probably be World War II. Maybe. I'd probably change World War II. Just because the Germans, they killed like over 6 million Jews. Like, damn. It's a lot of lives.
Honestly, I don't know.
So would it be 9/11? Would that be the event you want to change?
I would change anything. I would keep everything leading up to the exact moment.
God. Damn. He said he'll let the 10 million people die.
Dude, I'll fucking change COVID. That way I ain't got to wear a mask. Well, my girl ain't got to wear a mask because I'd be dead.
I'm with it. All right. So if he could change one awful event, it'd be COVID. COVID never happened. Cool. But moving on.
It's been a pain in my ass for 2 years.
Yeah, you're telling me. What if you were offered the opportunity to go to space? What would you do?
I've got a great reality show.
This is so awesome.
All right, you ready for this? So, you send 4 people to space that don't know shit about space.
Oh, God.
So, you send these 4 people to space. Don't know shit.
Don't know shit.
You film it. And they've got to survive a week in space.
Right. In space, or like in a spaceship?
No. Spaceship in space.
Okay.
Say like the space center or whatever the.
Right. Or just the spaceship they get sent out there in.
Because you know, like they do, like train, like people got like go insane and stuff. Like now,
right.
4 random people from off the street.
Oh god! So what if both of us got tossed out into space?
What if? I would thrive.
Oh, me too. I would thrive. I'd be sitting there floating. I'd be eating all that astronaut food. I'd be chilling.
Dude.
I'd lose some weight.
Have you eaten an astronaut?
Yeah, those dry meals.
Yeah.
Yeah, those things are actually not that bad. I've had ice cream. I've had like a meatloaf. And I've had, I had like a cookie. Like a dessert.
Meatloaf?
Yeah. It wasn't that bad.
Really?
Oh. Yeah. It was just dehydrated. It was just like, you had to put water in, you know what I'm saying?
Nah. The other foods are weird, but yeah, they're not that bad. I think it'd be cool.
Yeah, no, definitely. If I had the opportunity to go to space, I'd probably go. I want to go skydiving.
Dude, when's the next time you're going to freaking go to space? I'd go on Jeff Bezos' blue penis.
You'd go on what? On Jeff Bezos what? Y'all heard it here, folks. Okay, he said he'd jump on Jeff Bezos' blue penis.
Hold on. All right. Just because I said this, now I've got to Google it.
God. So, Christian, do you remember that show, Last Man on Earth? I know you know that show. You showed me that show, I think.
Yeah, with, I don't even remember.
Zach Galifianakis, I think.
No, it's not Zach Galifianakis, actually.
What's his name? The guy that looks just like him.
Yes, I know. I don't know what his name is.
But so what would you do if you were the last bat on earth? What would you do? Go. Just like in the show.
Hold on.
Me?
Hold on.
I'm running out butt naked.
What?
I'm running out. I'm running around butt naked outside. If I'm the last man on earth, I'm running out free willy nilly. Woo! I am free.
I don't remember what I said. There it is. I gotta go back. Cause I mentioned blue penis.
I mentioned blue penis. This has been stuck in your mind now.
Yeah. Blue Origin spaceship looks like a penis. It looks like a dildo.
I mean, he didn't have to shape it like that, man.
He did not have to shape it like that, but he did.
But he did. He chose to. The engineers said this is for maximum. And I mean they, maximum.
They brought out the plans. They were like, but sir, this looks like a dick.
It's okay. It'll cut through the air really well. It's
okay. I love it.
It'll penetrate the Earth's atmosphere really well.
It'll penetrate the atmosphere just like your mom.
Jesus.
Zing!
So, you're the last man on Earth. What do you do? Go. Last man on Earth. First thing you last do when you wake up. Last man on
Earth, dude. So, if I'm the last man on Earth, it's like... Is there still, like, stuff? Like, is there zoos and shit?
Yeah, you know, you're just like the last man on Earth show. You're just the last person. You just wake up and you're the last human being on Earth. There's still animals. There's just plants, houses. Everything's still there. Everybody's stuff and belongings.
I'm going to steal me a damn 75-inch TV and a PlayStation 5.
I'd go do the same thing. I'd go to to one of the cell towers, get them up and running. So I can have internet.
Or, dude, even better, go get one of those VR things. Get like the biggest badass VR suit you could think of, and dude,
yes,
holy shit, dude, you could play some Avengers shit. You can be Spider-Man up in that. Bitch.
Matter of fact, no, fuck that. I'm going out to where that motherfucker is at that makes those Iron Man suit prototypes, and I'm getting me an Iron Man suit. Yeah, apparently I seen this guy on TikTok that makes these Iron Man suits, and they're
how is Elon Musk not Iron Man yet?
He probably has one. He just doesn't. There's probably one behind Lincoln's head at Mount Rushmore.
Oh yeah, in the 35x18 storage closet.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I think definitely it's back there. Some secret stuff happening.
I can see it.
Me, like I said, I'm running around butt naked outside first, and then I'm going to find some stuff that you know I never.
I'll run around butt naked without the end of the world.
Shenanigans, you won't do it.
Not right now. I got to piss so bad.
Oh, God.
I'm on my fourth beer.
Oh, man. I'm only on my second. That is great.
Pansy.
That's because I had six earlier today. Calm down.
Oh, wow. I got to hold my Peter closed right now.
Small dong community.
Dude, it's crazy. I can do it with like two fingers.
Oh my God.
Plus two hands.
If I'm the last man, dude, I'm doing everything I want to do that I never could do. And
I'll go hit some golf balls off the damn Eiffel Tower. That'd be awesome.
Oh yeah, dude. I'd hit golf balls everywhere that I thought that'd be awesome. I'd go break some shit.
It's like that scene in I Am Legend where he's just hitting golf balls off the
Intrepid?
Tree. Yeah.
Off the Intrepid, yeah. The battleship.
Yeah.
That's great. Hell yeah. You want to go ahead and close this out, Christian, since you got to go pee?
Yeah, but that's going to do it for your Unofficial Boys podcast. Be sure to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, TikTok.
Yep.
And go listen to us on Spotify. Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and we've got a website coming soon. We've been working on it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
But for now, have a great fucking day.
Yeah, y'all take it easy. Check us out. Peace.